su deseo, señor.
Once in all, my wish.
Whatever, boss, is the last time.
All right, how about a final meal?
Do you really want to eat that slop?
This is more like it.
Now, why don't you start smoking just now?
You two are up to something.
We're up to our necks in smoke.
No, these delays are not coincidental. It's part of your plan, whatever it is.
Man's a sharpest attack.
Yeah, we should have known we'd never be able to fool him.
Might as well admit it.
Yeah, look, we'll level with you, Colonel. You see, we're really hooked on cigarettes, and we smoked our last pack of...
Attention! Listos!
Oh, here we go again.
Colonel, listen, please, just give us another... Another few minutes.
Apunte!
Come on, just a few more minutes.
I know it doesn't mean much to you, but
then
it means an eternity to us. Sir.
Then we're going
to
be out of your head.
You having trouble with that, honey?
No, but the memories were good, though.
Memories?
I guess you were talking about my tie.
I guess you were thinking about Robert.
Oh, yeah. I was. It's... We had a lot of close calls together. I find it very difficult to believe that Yanana didn't come through on this one.
Are you sure you're up to this today?
No. But I'll do it anyway. For Robert and Anna's sake. Come on, honey. Let's go.
Who you were.
I didn't know who you were either. I just knew I liked you.
Then I liked you too. And you know what? I'd have loved you even if you hadn't turned out to be my daughter. But I'm certainly glad you are.
So am I. Stay right.
I want to tell you that your mother and I love you very, very much. Perhaps more than regular parents.
Yeah.
How come you're not like regular parents? You could have told me you were my mommy and daddy.
Yeah, we should have.
Didn't you want me to know? Were you ashamed of me?
No, darling, no. We couldn't be prouder of you.
You're the most important thing in our lives.
You reckon you can forgive us?
Do you love mommy?
Your mother and I loved each other very much before you were born. It makes you very special.
A love child.
What's a love child?
It's just a child born out of love. And it just means that she'll be surrounded by love for all her life.
Promise you'll love me forever?
Forever.
Promise.
Okay. I'll forgive you. Don't ever do that again.
Every moment, I've never loved anyone more than I've loved you. I've got a great big aching hole in me.
Yeah, I know. I feel it, too.
I don't know how I'm going to live for the next month.
It's going to seem like years.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final boarding call for Flight 464, departing for London in 10 minutes. Final boarding call for Flight 464.
That's my flight.
I know.
I don't want to let you go.
I want you to go. Anymore. And I love you right at this moment. See you in a month.
Game is finally over. I knew that we would win. Oh, and lady, the lessons we have learned have helped us.
You haven't changed your mind.
Nope.
Robin's going to the service with us. Won't you reconsider? For her sake.
Mother around back and then bring the car around.
Okay.
Why do we always have to travel in a pack?
Because we love each other so much.
Oh, man, that was lovely. I wish I'd said that.
I'll be right there.
Hi, Nick.
Did you sleep all right?
Well as could be expected, I guess.
Sorry, we have to run. We have to go to an appointment.
Commissioner Scorpio's memorial service. I know, AJ told me.
Oh, well, we shouldn't be gone more than just a few hours.
Oh, I'll be fine. Are you going to be okay?
Well, yes, yes. What do you mean?
Are you sure? I mean, I know how hard it was for you to deal with my father's death, and he was just a patient. This must be horrible since you've known these people for years.
Well, it's true. The longer you know someone, the harder it is.
Monica?
Yes?
We're waiting.
Okay, I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Bye.
My father's upset that he can't go, but Mother's right.
Did you know that chocolate produces the same chemical reaction in your brain that you get when you're falling in love? Anna told me that.
I'm here.
I'm gonna miss her a lot, you know that. And Robert. I've been thinking today a lot about when Robert and Luke were palling around years ago. They were incorrigible.
Don't start this, please.
Robert was a real good friend to me all these years. The way he stood by me when I was accused of Brock's murder. And he stood by us when Terry was in the hot seat. And you know what I still feel bad about? When that whole thing happened with Lucas, I didn't come through for him.
You know, don't be this hard on yourself.
Feel really bad. But I tried to keep Lucas from him even when I thought Robert was Lucas's father.
Robert forgave you.
Yeah, he did. But I always thought that somehow I was going to get a chance to make it up to him. And now we're having coffee and cake for his friends after his memorial service.
Robin is going to need your love and your support right now.
Yeah, I'd like to be there for Robin. I'm worried about her, though. I hope she's finally accepting the fact that her parents are dead. She's not going to cling to false hope the way Mac is.
I'm not going to memorial service for people who aren't dead.
Not even for Robin?
Especially for Robin. Hardly she understands how I feel. I don't want her thinking I'm a hypocrite.
You're making this really hard for her, Mac. She needs you.
Look, she's got you, and she's got Sean, and she's got Tiffany, and half of Port Charles, all right? She'll be fine.
And you'll be here, wallowing in your refusal to accept the truth.
Robert and Anna are not dead, Holly. We have no proof to believe that they are dead.
Sean said that the pictures clearly show Robert, Anna, and Faisal on that ship moments before it blew up. You know that they truly are gone. Denying it is just another way of mourning.
If that's what you want to think, fine. Okay, but just let me mourn my own way. I'm giving you the right to go to the service. Don't think you can force me to join you.
I'm not forcing you to do anything. I just know that if you don't go, one day you'll be sorry that you didn't get to say goodbye properly.
I don't need to sit in church and listen to every Tom, Dick, and Harry immortalize my brother. Don't think that I'll ever forget what it took for us to finally respect each other, all right? You think I'll ever forget how he stood by me when I tried to establish myself in Port Charles? Or how I could forget his temper, or his laugh, or how a chauvinistic attitude drove Anne up a wall, or how much he loved his own daughter? No, Holly, I don't need reminders. I'll never forget him.
I know you won't. But you have forgotten one thing.
What's that?
You've forgotten how to cry.
Looking for something, Miss Mickey?
I was looking for a deck of cards. I wanted to play a little solitaire while everyone was away.
Oh.
Do you know where they are?
There are decks of cards in the den. I'll get one for you.
Jennings, actually, I'm not really in the mood for playing cards. I'm just lonely. I think the coffee's still hot.
Would you care for cream and sugar?
Oh, no, I was going to pour you a cup.
Well, I've already had two cups.
Indulge me, please. I am bored.
Very well. Just a spot of cream and no sugar.
Okay.
Miss Nicky, this makes me very uncomfortable.
Really? Well, you seem like such a big part of the family. You've been with the Corner Maids a long time, haven't you?
Oh, yes. I started working as a butler when they lost Stella. She was a very charming woman, and...
It's so beautiful here. Not like my house at all. You know, they say that money can't buy you happiness. But you wouldn't know it from this place. Are Alan and Monica as happy as they really seem?
I make it a policy never to discuss the family's private lives. And that is not a yes or no answer, by the way. Now, I really think that I should get you that deck of cards. I also think you should know that you are not the first young woman to pass through this house asking similar questions. And somehow I don't think you'll fare any better than the others.
I think we better be off.
Oh, hi.
Hi-ho.
Sorry, I'm late.
Okay.
Okay, we're just getting ready to go.
Nothing wrong, is there?
No, just a bad case of nostalgia, I guess. I passed Jake's on my way, and I couldn't resist stopping.
Well, there must be a story in that one. It's a little early for beer, isn't it?
Yeah, it's where I got to know the commissioner. We'd both had it with something or other, and we really tied one on.
Well, that's a good way to get rid of frustration.
Yes. A technique I may resort to before this day is over. We should have had a hell of a friendship.
I heard you drive up.
Holly and Robin will be down. Just a minute.
Good night, thanks.
I wish you were coming with us, Mac.
I just can't, Tiffany.
I was hoping you'd be there just to lend me moral support.
I'm sure you'll say exactly the right thing, Sean.
Hi, Robin. Hi, Holly. How are you?
Okay.
I'm so glad you're coming with us.
Yeah. I finally realized that you guys are right. Hope you're not mad at me, Uncle Mac.
Me mad? No. And Robin, I can never be mad at you. I just can't do it, that's all.
I know. I know you love them, too. And I missed you there today.
We really should be going, sweetheart.
I know.
You have everything?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
I'll see you later, Mac.
Later. I really am sorry, you know.
I know. Robin's being very brave, Mac, but she needs you.
Because of the big crowd.
Robert and Anna had a lot of friends in the city.
Yes, it's a very sad day for Port Charles.
I guess we all thought they were invincible.
None of us are.
At least until you're to the other side of the draw.
Service, which takes place today, is expected to be attended by state and national dignitaries, as well as friends and family of the revered Mr. and Mrs. Robert Scorpio, who met their deaths.
Keep it happening.
Robbie? Be very careful what you say.
Papa Bear is bellowing his protective roar. Kind of like that, too. It shows another dimension of your personality.
But what you know about love, family, huh? Tell me.
Here we go.
Responsibility,
again.
Absolutely nothing.
Now, how would you know?
You had all in the palm of your hand, and you destroyed it.
Yeah, I destroyed it.
How can you believe that I'd have it in me to kill my own brother?
You killed your own parents.
Robert told you that? You said I killed him?
Stop it.
Let me tell you something. There's more to our fraternal relationship than you could ever dream of. Certainly more than he's made you privy to. He's going around telling people I knocked off my parents. I can't believe it.
They died in a plane crash and you were the pilot. You don't deny that, do you? Listen to me! If he dies, I'm going to see to it that you do. Believe that.
Look, if we get through all this, and we will, why would you want to help me?
For myself and for someone else.
Hey, I'm going with you. Listen, not this time. I need you here. I need a favor. Big one, in fact.
Sure, ask away.
You heard me saying earlier that, Robin and Holly are going to move into the house. Well, I'm going to feel better if you're out there looking after both of them.
Yeah, you got it.
I'm going to find my wife, and I'm going to try to bring her back, son.
Listen to me. Promise me that you're going to take care of yourself.
Hey, wait a minute. There's the big
brother. Promise me!
It's a promise. Now, get out of your place and get some sleep. I go upstairs and tell Robin she gets to live with her favorite uncle.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today to honor two people who had a very profound effect on all of our lives. Robert Scorpio and Anna Devane Scorpio. Two people who were loved by everyone who met them and knew them. Especially me. You're going to have to forgive me. I think that they both deserve much more than just a written speech. And I wrote this. I sweat bullets over this one. Until someone said to me, why don't you just say what you feel? So I think that they both deserve something from the heart. And the heart is something that they both knew quite a bit about. You know, in this thing, I was going to use phrases like intelligent, compassionate. Oh, courageous, a lot of things. But the driving force in their life was that they cared for other people. And that feeling, that feeling got them into trouble quite a few times. In fact, I can remember the first time they ever met. I was head of the World Security Bureau then, the WSB. Individually, they were two of the best agents I'd ever trained or worked with. And then, they met face to face for the first time.
Corporate Scorpio meet Anna Devane. Now, Sweet and O'Reilly already know Anna. They've worked with her on a couple of missions.
You've got to figure a way in and to figure a way out.
This isn't going to work, Sean. You put me with Miss Devane.
Devane, please.
Robert, I made a decision. Subject.
What's it going to be? Friends or enemies?
I think that's entirely up to you.
Let's get one thing straight. I'm the boss.
I'm sure that all of you probably think that this was a match made in heaven. Well, it was hardly that. They detested one another on sight. But eventually that dislike turned to respect, and respect turned to friendship. Friendship so deep that... It carried on no matter who they were with or what they were doing. They both shared a dedication to doing what had to be done, what they believed in, no matter what the cost.
I think we all have to agree that if we were going to be taken hostage, and may it please never happen again.
Please, please.
We were very lucky to have Anna with us.
Here.
No, that's okay. I don't deserve any of that.
Yes, you do. You got us through this without a single fatality.
But I couldn't have done it without any of you guys. I think we made a very good team.
Does that mean that on October 11th, for the rest of our lives, we have to celebrate Hostage Day?
I mean, my two friends, Robert and Anna, they never wanted glory, praise, the limelight. What they were after... And what they seeked was justice, peace. And fairness. And they found that because they demanded of themselves excellence. And they demanded it from everyone else around them. I think we were all pretty lucky to have them in our lives.
I wasn't sure if your work was more important than I was.
Don't be ridiculous.
No, really. You as much as said it, and you haven't said that you love me for a long time.
Holly. I love you more than life itself. If anything were to happen, I wouldn't let it. I couldn't.
This dedication to excellence, well, they realized, too, that they were very lucky to be in our lives. Because we love them. And in return, they loved us back.
Brave,
Mac, but she ladies and gentlemen, I didn't realize that this was going to be as difficult as it is. So I'm going to stop being maudlin for a while, and I'm just going to tell you about the man. The man first. Now, Robert was a very obstinate, stubborn, strong-willed Aussie who didn't suffer fools well, hated bureaucracy, and was pretty chauvinistic from time to time, according to Anna. But he was a good man and a good friend. I think we'd all be very, very lucky if we ever saw his like again. Robert had this knack for getting people out of the darkest situations.
Anna and Robert are coming today just to see you.
Point one. And point two, well, it's an opening the other day. Had a couple of bad Irish jokes instantly for you. For how much bad you can make them sound.
But was it something that was even stronger than Robert's sense of humor was his sense of justice?
Bobby, don't. Bobby.
One thing you could always count on Robert for was his honesty. Now, Anna was another story entirely. Anna was a woman, a lady.
You
was admired.
Well, I didn't want you to
Thank you so much
for hosting our wedding. I mean, that's so wonderful.
It means
a lot to us.
Thank you.
And you,
I would like to propose a toast to the bride to be.
Oh, wow.
To Anna. May her marriage be as long and as happy as mine was to Edward.
Oh,
she was a crackerjack agent, a stunning beauty. Lousy cook. Passable housekeeper, but she was a sensational wife and mother, which brings me to something I haven't touched on yet, and that is their beautiful daughter, Robin, who meant more to them than anything else in this world.
Come on. There. That's better now. You want to talk about it?
I just don't want you to leave. Is that wrong?
Of course not. It's only natural. You're going to feel a little bit sad. But, you know, I can't be with you always. And soon, well, soon you're going to be part of a whole new family. You've got two families. And too many little girls in the world have got that. Four people. I love them very, very dearly. But then again, you're very, very rare. And you're very lucky, too. Almost as lucky as we are to have you.
Hello.
And there's so much of them in her. Intelligence, beauty, sophistication, a little bit of stubbornness, compassion, and above all else, courage. Lots of courage. Even though Robert and Anna are gone, they really haven't left us because there's so much of them and their daughter. And I know for a fact that they will always be in her heart. As I said before, I think we're all very, very lucky to know Robert and Anna Scorpio and have our lives touched by two individually unique people. We're a very unique couple. I don't think that we should today mourn their loss. I think what we should all do is celebrate their lives.
Please excuse the interruption, but there's a few things I have to say about my brother. I think it's no secret to everybody here that Robbie and I didn't always see eye to eye. Well, Robbie was the smart one. I love you, big brother. And I'm going to miss you. We're all going to miss him. No, I know. And I can't take the place of Robert. But I'm going to give Robin the love and support and respect that she deserves. Did a good job, Robbie. She's a fine young lady. And I'm going to take care of her. Just like I promised.
You don't have to answer me right now. I mean, I realize that this is no bargain you're getting here, but...
Yeah.
Let's go home, love.
Tomorrow at 10, 9 Central, Tony's